Why would his son betray him like that? Kill his own father? Over some treasure? He seems so greedy.
Remember what I told you, boy. Assume nothing.
Well, sure. He didn't seem like a great father, but...
You only know half the story.
Yes.
You, didn't happen to find that whetstone.
We found no whetstone. This dagger belongs to the Reaver who took it.
They took most of the good stuff.
Oh? Well... The dagger you brought me is quite interesting, an artless design, but the construction is sound. Where in the temple did you find this?
In a Reaver's back.
Oh. Oh.
He mentioned he was part of a larger clan. Maybe they took the whetstone?
Quite possibly. I know I've seen this design before. Now, there is something else to tell you.
You gentlemen certainly know how to get around. Why don't you tell me how all this began with Baldur?
He just knocked on our door.
Baldur of Asgard just knocked on your door?
Yeah, he just showed up and started a fight. He said he wanted to know something. He said, I know what you are.
Oh, well, we'll circle back to that later. What exactly did he want to know?
That was on the floor,
he said I already knew what he wanted. Perhaps he mistook me for another.
That's quite interesting.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Fjorgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half god and half giant? Weird.
We'll pick this up later.
This waterfall is even bigger now that the water's dropped. That gate. We never did open it. Should we give it a try? So you were saying Odin was lonely? That's why he was always at war?
Nothing quite so simple. But I hoped that love might temper him and give us a chance for peace. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I could scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
So Odin and Freya could have been happy, but he only wanted her magic?
Aye. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Yeah!
One more for the collection. Another name.
Here, Drifle.
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
So Odin and Freya could have been happy, but he only wanted her magic?
Aye. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity. This gate.
You who walks among the living. My beloved Gulvig calls to me.
You want us to collect her?
Gulvig, save her.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell you.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom.
This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamlu. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Killed him. Oh no. We found a village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. But truth is, the sweaty Gorbag just got lucky.
Dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
I'm ready! Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Oh, that crystal's brimming again.
Chisel.
The tip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel. Neat trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea. happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything. Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles up ahead. What should we do?